Yo, welcome to the History of Perfume, where you're gonna get a whiff of everything you need to know about perfume.
Let's do it. Paco style, let's get him.
Today, we're gonna talk about the olfactive pyramid. Come on, man, I said olfactive. Thank you. It's the method Paco Rabanne uses to define a fragrance. And at the top, you have what's called the
head notes,
which basically describes the first 15 minutes of a fragrance's evaporation. They give that freshness, that zing-zing. It's the first impression, like how you should be on a blind date. The first impression is all important. You don't believe me?
Hi there.
Told you so. Then come the
heart notes.
3 hours strong after application. Heart notes are stronger. They lend a fragrance its character, its personality.
Boom!
Yeah, homie. Now take the
Lady Million.
It contains
sunbuck jasmine.
In India, it can be found in women's hair, teas, and the decorations of floats in religious festivals.
It's even said that the essence of jasmine encourages hair growth.
Afro.
You're welcome. Then at the bottom of the pyramid, you have the
base notes.
5 to 6 hours strong post-evaporation.
The deep notes.
Long-lasting. The very signature of the fragrance. Like in
Invictus.
You've got ambergris. And ambergris is the intestinal secretions of a
sperm whale.
Did he say sperm? But funky odor aside, it lets a perfume remain much longer on the skin. Dear, you're old. But given the short supply of ambergris, Rabanne's sorcery can create synthetic versions of these rare natural elements. And trust me, it's much better for the planet and its animals. Now, we're already out of time, but if you want to know more,
then catch us in our next episode.